Hello, and welcome to Isolation Basics, a video series designed to introduce fundamentals of digital isolation. In this video, we will review some basic standards and terminology of digital isolation. What is isolation? Isolation is a means of preventing DC, or uncontrolled transient currents, from flowing between two communicating points. An isolator is an insulator across which signal and power transfer can occur. In this example of isolation, the ISO 1176 allows communication between two different ground potentials while preventing high voltage from crossing the isolation barrier. This protects sensitive processors from high voltage transients. Why use isolation? Isolation is used as a means of protection when there is the possibility of high voltage surges that may damage equipment or harm humans. To prevent disruptive ground loops in systems with interconnections where large ground potential differences, or GPDs, may be present. Also, to enable communication between low and high side component transitions, such as in motor drive systems. Isolation standards. What are isolation standards and certifications? There are isolation standards for both component and product level certifications. Component level testing is for integrated circuits. Product level testing is for end user products. For isolation ICs, component standards are used to define terminology, essential ratings, characteristics, safety tests, and measurement methods for three component scopes: optoisolators, digital or non-optoisolators, and a combined standard for optocouplers and digital isolators. These tests are performed at a device level and are defined and designed to detect whether an isolator's internal insulation could break down under varying operating conditions over time. Isolation standards for component level apply to the semiconductor level, and equipment standards apply at the system level. EMC and emission standards apply at the semiconductor level. TI's digital isolation products are tested to meet basic and reinforced isolation levels across most industry standards. You can find a complete list of TI isolation certifications by device at www.ti.com/isolation. Click on the Isolated Certifications tab to view the complete list. Isolation terminology. What are safety insulation levels? Basic, double, and reinforced isolation. Basic insulation is a single layer of insulation protecting from a single incidence of fault. It offers no protection once a single fault has occurred. Double insulation is two layers of insulation levels. Reinforced insulation is a single point of insulation that is equivalent in protection to double insulation, offering a remaining layer of protection in the event that a single fault occurs. Reinforced ICs help to realize high voltage protection of a component at the system level. To learn more about reinforced isolation, visit TI.com and look for High Voltage Reinforced Isolation Definitions and Test Methodologies White Paper, lit number SLYY 063. What are creepage and clearance? To meet safety standards, an isolator's external circuit spacing, which is the distance between package leads, is required to meet minimum distances called creepage and clearance. These specifications are intended to limit the working voltages and peak voltages that may occur due to degradation along the package surface or in the operating environment. Creepage distance is the shortest distance between two conductive leads across the isolation barrier and measured along the surface of insulation. Clearance distance is the shortest distance between two conductive leads across the isolation barrier and measured through air. It's important to understand the differences between isolation voltages in the datasheet. Repetitive peak isolation voltage is the withstand capability of the isolation against repetitive peak voltages as a normal operating mode. Working voltage is the specified long-term withstand capability of the isolation barrier, also as a normal operating mode. Maximum transient isolation voltage is the peak impulse withstand capability against transients lasting 60 seconds. This specifies peak tolerance to oval voltage and arcing. Surge voltage is the highest instantaneous voltage pulse within a specified time and specified wave shape. This specifies performance pertaining to lightning strikes, with a minimum 10 kV specification to meet reinforced standards. Common mode transient immunity is the maximum rate of change of ground potential differences that the isolator can withstand without bit errors. CMTI indicates the level of immunity to ground noise and impacts signal integrity across the insulator. CMTI is measured in kilovolts per microsecond. You'll find here a summary of isolation terminology, in brief, that covers some of the basic definitions and terminology covered in this discussion. For a more detailed list, visit www.ti.com and look for lit number SLYY063. We hope you have enjoyed learning a little bit more about isolation standards and terminology. To learn more about TI isolation products, videos, and blogs, please visit www.ti.com/isolation.